You are the best. Don't ask me. up.
Thank you.
Just gotta understand. I'd like you to say hello to a friend of ours. It's those two of us. So we've been nice to do walk. Welcome to the guitar from Milwaukee, Mr. Daryl Salmacis. Song about a piece of American history. This is all about the gold rush. And it's called Deep in the Motherland.
being with us tonight.
You see, because Chester's bass drum pedal is broken, and for all drummers in the audience, they know what kind of trauma this is. Now, at the moment, Chester is kicking Andy, the roadie, who's behind the bass drum. Chester's kicking him up the backside, aren't you, Chester? See, there's Andy. Give Andy a nice round of applause. And luckily enough, we do have a hermaphrodite in the road crew as well. Andy? He's busy. Anybody know a joke? This is the sign of a true performer. A breakdown and doesn't know what to say. Now what am I bid for this drum head? Do I hear $2? $4? $6? Who wants to buy a drum roadie?
Thank you.
there's been some very bad publicity recently.
Thank you.
Did anybody see us last time we toured America? Always been. Choose to sit around a bit since then, but we're going to do a song now that we did on the last tour. It's from Wind and Wuthering. And it's written by Mr. Banks. And it's called One for the Vine. Thank you. hang on a minute while I just rearrange the set. Right, we're going to play another new song. We're playing a lot of new songs tonight. This one is called The Lady Lion.
Thank you.
Listen to Uncle Phil. And this is the story of Romeo and Juliet.
Oh my God! Oh my God!
Star-crossed lovers. Star-crossed lovers. But unfortunately, both virgins. Now, Romeo was 16 years old, and he was very, very horny. And Juliet was 16 years old, and she had very large bumps. Now, Romeo was prone to fits of unprecedented passion. And tonight, it being a Saturday night, he felt that his fits of unprecedented passion was welling up inside him. And so he decided to ring his young lady, Juliet, on the telephone and ask her out to a drive-in movie. And we all know what happens at drive-in movies. Even we do it. Anyway, of course, Juliet accepted the invitation, and within half an hour, Romeo had borrowed his father's car, and they were at the back of the park, watching the B-movie. This is Juliet, this is Romeo. And very quietly, Romeo slipped his hand inside Juliet's dress, and started to feel one of her bumps. Well, Juliet was a bit taken aback, but suddenly, Romeo jumped on top of her and started fondling her buttocks. Juliet was very surprised at this, but she soon got into the party spirit and she started fondling Romeo's buttocks. So there they were, Romeo and Juliet, fondling buttocks. Well, this was okay for a couple of minutes, but it got a bit boring, and so Romeo slid off Juliet's dress, pulled off her diaper, removed her vest, and there she was, stark naked in front of him. Well, Romeo quickly tried to unbutton his trousers. He had to do this himself because Juliet was tied to the steering wheel. And he tried to pull them down. Excuse me. Anyway, there he was, Romeo, stark naked in front of Juliet, stark naked. But just as he was about to approach Juliet, she noticed from the clock on the dashboard, she said, "Romeo, Romeo, stop, stop, stop. Untie me and put my clothes back on." And Romeo said, "You can't leave me like this." And Juliet said, I must, otherwise we're going to miss the cinema show."
Yeah.
Well, it's about that time of night when we play our last song.
Stay all night!
Otherwise, we'll be here all night. Yeah.